Hey there, guys, I'm Hello Japan, and welcome back, finally, to a new episode of Let's Take a Crack At. Today, we are going to take a crack at Borderlands, the pre-sequel. So, what's my experience with the Borderlands series up to this point? I've played a good deal of the first one. I played about 10 hours of the second one, and that's about it. Now, I like them. They're very fun games. I really do quite enjoy them. But I don't know what it is. It's just one of those series that I just, for whatever reason, can't get myself to play. Now, I figured if I pick up the Handsome Jack collection, or the Handsome collection, rather, on the Xbox One, maybe it would be a good enough reason to actually give them a try again. And I figured before actually recording anything or even just playing it on my own, I might as well do a Let's Take a Crack At of the one Borderlands game I have not played up to this point, and that is the pre-sequel. So, besides Borderlands 1 and Borderlands 2, I did play all the way through, relatively recently finishing, the Tales from the Borderlands game, the point-and-click adventure-style game from Telltale. And I really did like that. That was a very, very, very fun game. One of my favorite games from this year, from 2015. And I hope that, you know, that and the pre-sequel. Now, I know for sure there is at least one character that is in the pre-sequel that we met in Tales from the Borderlands. So, yeah. Anyway, we are recording this with the Elgato HD 60 Pro, I think it's called. So this is the first, like, big video I've recorded using it. So let me know how it looks, so everything runs, if everything seems like it's running pretty smoothly, and the overall quality. Because I'm quite pleased with the card so far. Quite pleased with it indeed. So there is going to be one announcement at the very end of the video. And I'll probably bring it up again during episode 49. But it has to do with episode 50. Kind of a special thing I'm going to try. But regardless, before we get started, let's jump into the options menu. Now, I know it's not a PC game, but we can still take a peek at the options. So, in the gameplay menu setting, or in the gameplay options, you get pretty much everything you need. Now, one thing is item rotation. That's kind of a strange thing. Adjust the control scheme for inspecting items. It's kind of interesting that they actually have a few additional settings like this that you normally would not see and most console games, and most notably so. Okay, besides that, it's all pretty standard, par for the course, you know, kind of thing. But besides that, if we jump into, well, not audio. Audio is, again, pretty normal. Video, I believe it is? Yes. It actually has an FOV setting. Now, if you're playing on your couch, you could probably have this down to 70 is what it normally is. That's what it was defaulted to. Normally, I play my games at 90. On PC, and if console offers, I usually play it at 90. But we're gonna bump it up to 110 and see how that looks. If it looks like garbage, we'll bump it down. But keep in mind, I am actually recording this at a computer, essentially. So it is a little different for me than it is for you, potentially. And besides that, you have the borders. So if you have an extra wide monitor, whatever, you can set it up accordingly. And beyond that, colorblind mode, which is good to see. Not colorblind myself, so I'm not gonna tinker with that. But yeah, besides that, everything is as it should be. Good stuff. So with that, let's jump into a new game. Now, I might have to remove the intro cinematic here. I'm not too sure, just because it is a licensed song. I might leave it in, I might not. We'll see what ends up happening. But regardless, as soon as I hit new game, we will have 1 hour with the game. And once that hour is up, I will let you know what I thought at the very end, as well as let you know about episode 50. So with that, let's get started. This is Let's Take a Crack At episode 48, Borderlands, the pre-sequel. Let's get started. Defend and protect. Well, that was a bit of an intro. Now, whether or not you saw it, I don't know. I really can't say. Anyway, yeah, welcome. So, if you did miss the intro, and I wasn't allowed to actually include it, The four main original characters to the game were, of course, Athena, who we did see in the Tales from the Borderlands, which was, she was a pretty interesting character. I quite liked her in that game. Don't believe I'm going to play as her, though, but she is in this game. A guy named Willem, he is the enforcer. He looks interesting. Don't know if I'd play as him either. Bring in the law. We have Nisha. Okay. Interesting. And then, of course, Claptrap, which, I don't know. Claptrap has always been an interesting character to me. I've enjoyed him in some circumstances. But for the most part, he can be kind of annoying. And then here we have Aurelia? Sure. I have no idea who she is. She must be a character within the game here. But we're going to be playing as Jack. So, now whether or not that's too lore friendly, I don't know. But yeah, I think it'd be a good fit. Plays Handsome Jack. Let's go for it.
Hunter, and thank you for answering Hyperion's summons. Unfortunately, the Helios space station is currently under attack by insane doll military forces. Please, take this echo device. Now, follow me. I can take you to your contractor liaison.
So this is kind of cool because it's actually running at 60 frames per second on Xbox One. Now, I know it does dip, and if I was to play it on PC, it would be better. But still, it's pretty cool and enjoyable. All right, let's go. Let's go. Sorry if you hear noises outside. I have my window open. That good old Borderlands loot and snatch and grab everything gameplay. It made me, when it first came out, when Borderlands 1 came out and I experienced it with my friends, it really made me a greedy player. I'd run ahead of them, all of them, and be like, mine, 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 mine. Now, whether or not it's a good thing, I don't know, but it was enjoyable at the time. What do we got here? There we go. All right, let's go.
Jack's waiting for a beer.
I'm coming, I'm coming, I'm coming.
Open for me, oh door. Jack's just around the corner. Let's go.
What? But I'm Jack. What?
Lots of Legion are really making a mess of this place.
Let's have some fun.
Vault Hunter sighted.
Submission is an area waypoint. Area waypoints give you the general location. Okay, so it's pretty much Borderlands. Borderlands.
Save me! Save me!
See a bad guy. I didn't remember how to play. It's been a while. All right, throw grenades. Good stuff. And the last time I played Borderlands with a controller was on console, so it's been a long time. On PS3, rather. So it's been a long time since I've played Borderlands on a console.
Damn it.
Might actually bump up the sensitivity a bit. Hey, buddy. That's what, am I a clone of Jack or something? Because I thought I was Jack. Whatever.
The last reason to kill this one. People think robots can't feel pain, but we actually feel it in slow motion with great intensity. This robot died in horrific agony.
Oh shit, that's kind of messed up.
That's awesome. Hey, you the vault hunters I hired.
The real Jack.
Oh, for the Legion.
The big one, reporting for duty.
Hey, my body double finally arrived. Wow,
you
sound attractive. Distractingly so.
So we're a body double. That's awesome. Dude, that's actually really cool.
Help, lots of help. I got
so,
no idea.
It's going to be two Jacks in the game.
I'm going to murder on for this space station, but they got me pinned.
That's so cool. Uh-oh. It's kind of cool because, yeah, there we go. So this Jack here is actually a decent guy. He's not a complete dickbag. He'll eventually turn into a dickbag, but I think so far he's not actually that mean. Get out of here. You okay? Okay, Jack, don't die over there. There's actually low gravity, which is a nice cool feature in this game. In the previous Borderlands, you could jump pretty high, because apparently the gravity is different on Pandora or something. But I think the most part, this game takes place almost exclusively on the moon, which is actually pretty cool. Shit, we need health. Health, please. There we go. There's some. Hold on a second, guys. I'm healing up. Don't shoot at me. Hey, that's not very nice. Vault Hunter, you suck. You know, after playing this, even just these few minutes I've been playing it now, it's Borderlands is a lot of fun. Borderlands is a really good series. And if you've never given it a try, I highly recommend probably picking up this. The first one's aged a little, not entirely too gracefully. if they do release an updated version of Borderlands 1 with the engine of this, or whatever the next Borderlands would be, then you would pick up 1. But I think for the most part, starting with 2 and the pre-sequel is actually a good place to begin.
You're busy. That's cool. I'll just bleed over here and
Italy
for a while.
Shut
it's
up.
A super fun way to pass the time, but yeah, don't mind me. Just the guy who hired you. Sorry, my.
Shut up, Jack.
Thank you. Sorry. Heart's pounding. Never been shot at before. Kind of fun, actually. Look, these crazy bastards attacked Helio Station right after I sent for you guys. If we can drive them off, we'll be free to go after that vault on the moon's surface.
Alrighty. So let's go ahead and get a reward and a new mission. Level up. You just leveled up. Leveling up permanently increases the amount. Of health you have and the amount of damage you deal. It almost immediately gives you full health and shields. So that's also a really cool thing is if you're on the...
You gotta hide and give it time to recharge. Hey, just let me activate the defense controls. A few seconds, we'll have turrets, force fields, laser wires. These assholes won't know what hit them.
Yeah, so when you level up or you're in a tight position, it's actually one of the most satisfying things I've experienced.
From Elpis, Pandora's moon.
Oh crap! Kill the turrets! Kill the turrets!
Yeah. So shield—it's basically like an overshield. If you've played any game that has an overshield before, same exact thing. Hide until it replenishes, and you're good to go.
All right. Plan B. If we can't take Helios back, we need to evacuate. Escape ships are this way.
Alrighty, Jack.
We must take this ground.
Jack's hey, following Jack. Let's go.
Jack. Who is that woman? I don't know. She leads these jackasses, I think. I don't know.
It's so cool.
It's a high five to
Jack and Jack. I love it. Oh, God, I'm coughing. Don't cough. That's disgusting. No one wants to hear that. Let's not do that.
Door. The escape ships are nearby.
You got it, real Jack. I have an addiction to opening every crate I see and seeing what's inside it. So, don't mind me. No, you forced me to quit the cutscene. Come on.
Oh, son of a taint.
Son of a taint. What? Oh, that's great.
Hey, it's that colonel. Execute plan and shoot that chick in the head.
Hello, Jack.
Okay, that's unnerving. Run!
Alrighty, well, don't bother with that thing.
Perfect. She destroyed the ships. We gotta find another way out the station. What the hell was that? I didn't sign up for this. No idea, but I get the feeling it could kill us with its brain, so, you know, keep running.
Jack, what the hell is going on? I'm getting reports of alarms all across Helios.
Nothing, sir. Nothing. Everything's fine. Just,
boss can be angry.
Trap units tried to French kiss a light socket, sir.
Need I remind that you are there to observe Pandora. Nothing more. If you incur any damages to the Helios space station, I will personally...
sorry, sir. We're losing connection. Sorry. Asshole.
What?
I called you an asshole because I thought I'd hung up. My bad.
We will speak again, John.
There's Elvis. That friggin' jamming signal is somewhere down on that cracked rock, messing up all the cool security stuff up here. You psychopaths! Son of a taint!
Go! Son of a taint again! What the hell is that?
I want this station, and I want to save the universe. The hell's that supposed to mean?
Oh, hi! Shield down! Stop! Don't hurt me! No, I do have another gun! Yo! They're pretty cruddy. They're not very good. Every guy, both the guns I have. The assault rifle and the pistol, they're just... they're not very good. Hang on, Jack. Real Jack, I'm... fighting stuff. What are you doing? Ooh, guns. Tyler Likey.
Everybody all right?
Everything else is kind of eh. I'll take it though. Holy shit, we got a lot of... Yo, explosives!
Nice try,
possible.
Freaking lunatics!
Shit!
How's that shield holding up?
It's good, but I'm being shot. I won't live. I won't live if I keep getting blown up like this. They're not letting out fire damage. Oh, holy shit. Keep missing though. Gross.
Doing? We don't even have a real military up here. They're just murdering workers and us
if we don't move it.
Yeah, it's kind of a dick move. Just murdering workers. Workers and loader bots. This is pretty much all they're killing. What? There's just a lot of crates around here for some reason. $1. Oh, that's good. That's good. And nothing. Okay. Where'd you go, Jack?
Well, I've got a stupid idea. We're gonna head to that moonshot cannon. Follow me. What is this moonshot thing we're headed for again? Basically a huge gun that shoots supplies down to the moon's surface like at about 1,000 miles an hour. We're gonna get in one of those containers and escape that way. And that's, survivable, is it? I don't know. Be a pretty cool way to die, though, huh?
I love this game. And that's why this series has always been so good, because it's my kind of humor. It's so funny.
You psychopath!
Oh! Cowardly fixed loader. Nice. Holy shit. This thing... it's basically shooting like little mini rockets. It's not very accurate though. Oh, nice. Level up. You've earned a skill point. Skill points allow you to customize your character with additional skills and specializations. Spend your skill points now to unlock your action skill, expandable assets. Ooh. Alrighty. So, this is... Yeah, so every character has their own different kind of left bumper, basically, ability, which lets them lay down a turret or... Or in the case of one of my favorite characters from Borderlands 2, the Gunzerker, he could wield two big guns at the same time. So it's kind of cool. Kind of a cool ability. So let's see what this one does. Press left bumper to summon two Digijacks to fight and die for you. Digijacks lose health constantly until they die. When a Digijack dies, a new one will be summoned near you. Press and hold LB to end it. Okay. That's kind of cool. That's actually really interesting. Let's give it a try in a second. We don't really need to right now.
I have no idea why these doll guys wanted Jack dead. I had suspicions. Money, revenge, that's it. Whoever needed a reason out here.
Oh, and as well, anyone unfamiliar, one of these, this thing that opened down there, that's basically a continue spot. It creates a digital copy of your DNA. that is what the actual explanation is, and it just checkpoints you. If you die, you'll just respawn there. Kind of cool. Long-winded reasoning behind it, but it is still kind of cool. Badass ranks. You have earned a badass rank. Interesting. Badass ranks are awarded for completing challenges. Badass ranks are an avenue of growth for you across all of your characters. Earning ranks sometimes grants you reward tokens. Turn in tokens in your Echo device to earn bonuses for all your... Okay, cool. Interesting. Redeem. Of course, gun accuracy. Cool. I remember they introduced that in Borderlands 2, but I don't remember it very well. Because like I said, I only spent like 10 hours with Borderlands 2. And, yeah, man, that's actually pretty neat. Oh, so there's the rarity of some items. If it's white, it's the most common, and then green, blue, purple, orange from there. So for probably the duration of this video, we're only going to see greens. Maybe we'll see one blue. But, yeah, nothing more than that. Yeah, still greens. Power shot, interesting. We'll switch it out. Even though it's weaker, we'll still switch it out. It's a repeater. We'll take it, though. Oh, wrong one. Fuck it. I usually pick up all my stuff anyway just to sell it. Or all the guns just to sell them. Whatever. Not gonna be picky. Let's go. Don't wanna die in here. Come on, real Jack. yeah. Bit of a psychopath. Let's shoot him. That has to be a saying I need to start saying is son of a taint. Yo! Every time you want to reload. Oh shit, that's awesome! No way, you get to throw the pistol. That's really cool. Where's he going? Come here. That's so cool! There we go. Easy as that. Uh-oh. Oh, this game is so cool. I need to go back and play the earlier ones too. Like I said, probably gonna skip over one just because it is a little dated, but oh, it's so cool, man.
Let's go.
From Jackie Boy.
Yeah. Our story just began with us getting off a bus. This sounds all explosive and stuff.
Complimenting the prisoner.
So that was Mordecai. He was one of the original Vault Hunters from Borderlands 1, as well as Lilith we saw there. And at the very, very beginning of the game, which I think I showed off... Again, I don't know what I'm going to have to cut from the very intro of the game. But there was also Brick there, who is being held up by... Mordecai, I think, was there? I don't know. But yeah, that's also another one of the characters. Anywho, let's go. Go for it, man. We're going to die here if you don't.
Damn it, something's jamming the elevator up there. Figure something out. All right, weird idea. Let me work the loading terminal.
Or how about I shoot it? It's a loader bot stuck up there. Okay.
All right, you get into the moonshot cylinder and ride it up.
Ooh, what?
Watch your step. That'll be a hell of a fall. This might be a problem because I got a thing with heights and this is a pretty big bullet.
Hold on, I'm gonna spin the cylinder.
Oh shit. Hello?
Make it up there. Free up the elevator so I can join you.
Dang, it's a loader bot stuck in there.
Hey man, is everything okay up there?
Yes. Yeah.
That way stays tight. Eh, no big deal though, they can't feel pain. Just bash them out of there. All these loaders bum me out. It's no wonder Dahl took us over so easily. I need more soldiers.
Badasses. Like you.
You mean like you? Me being you and you being me? Even though I'm the better of you, even though you're the original? Yeah, okay. Sure. Whoops.
Woo, we made it. All right, we just gotta get into a moonshot.
A crate of Hyperion shall not...
After we kill this asshole.
I got him, don't worry.
Good for you.
Is he the only asshole left?
Twice you've saved my life. Now we just gotta... Oh, for what? The auto shot controls are damaged. Someone's gotta stay back and launch the pods manually. I'd suggest my body double, but he's way too hot to die.
Getting uncomfortable now.
Alright, new plan. I'll stay behind. I need you down on the moon. You gotta find that jamming signal and shut it down. Otherwise, we'll never get control of the moon base and we can kiss that vault goodbye. You're gonna stay and die? Shouldn't we switch places or something? Now you saved my life a couple of times, I'm repaying the favor. Besides, I'm a hero, baby. Self-sacrifice is part of the job. Oh, good. A health machine. I had one put in here after a worker had an accident and lost his torso. Better heal up before your trip down to the moon.
What? Lost his torso?
Ammo too.
Hello?
Here.
That's not a thing.
We get a moonshot container up here. Normally we'd load some supplies, but this time you're the cargo.
Yeah, we'll sell this. Got a bunch of money.
Container ought to do the trick.
And we're full. Cool. Hi. We good? We good? We good to go? Am I done? Hello? There we go.
So the container's all ready. Just get into it.
Hang on, I'm distracted.
I'm
money.
So regretting this decision.
Yeah, I'll see you after you shut down that jamming signal.
Okay, hang on me. I'm looking around. There's money and stuff in places. I'm a loot whore. I need it.
Come on, hurry. We gotta get to Elpis.
Shut up. I need my fix. See, I would have missed this $3, Jack. I would have missed $3 because of you.
Cool, I'm closing the container. Watch your limbs. Loading you into the delivery chamber. This is gonna be loud. It's slightly awesome.
You're telling me Jack. Handsome Jack, the guy who murdered my boyfriend, stayed behind while you escaped?
Like hell.
Whether his decision was heroic or purely strategic, I can't say. But if Jack hadn't stayed behind to eject the pod, I might well have died on Helios.
Your story is making Handsome Jack kind of sympathetic. I hate it.
All right, we're ready to fire. Whenever you're ready, I'll shoot you to Concordia. It's the biggest town on Elpis. I know someone there who can help you find that jamming signal.
So, Lilith there mentioned that her boyfriend was killed by Jack. Her boyfriend was... Roland, I believe his name was Roland, and he was also one of the original Vault Hunters from the first Borderlands, which I think he was killed off in Borderlands 2, if I'm not mistaken.
Not ready yet?
Interesting. Well, anyway, it's cool how they kind of weaved narrative from nothing. The first game was pretty narrative loose. It had a story to it, but it was pretty vague. And then from 2 in this one, they built a story, which is interesting. Anyway, let's go.
Differential gets too harsh. So, here's my plan. When you're ready, open the door and follow me to my oxygen bubble. Sound good? Don't answer. Conserve your oxygen.
I don't want my eyeballs popping like grapes. That sounds horrible. I need air, lady. Oh, we're going all the way over here. Alrighty, that's fun. Oh, so you can survive as long as your health. Okay. So I can survive about 100 seconds, because each second roughly is one health. Okay, cool. I like that. Whoa. Okay, so there's a bit of verticality to this game.
Here, I'll turn on this air dome generator so you can get a breather.
Oh my god, this is cool. A lot of people didn't care much for this game because it was not nearly as good as Borderlands 2. But I'm quite enjoying it. This is actually pretty neat. Again, I'm a sucker for anything that stays consistent.
It'd be embarrassing if you died now.
Yeah, shut up. I know. I'm coming. You can open that for me? Thank you. I almost died.
Everybody good? Nice to meet ya. I'm Janie Springs, junk dealer. Who are you?
The name's Jack, babe.
Well... Nice to meet you, Jack.
So what are you doing here?
There's a jamming signal somewhere around here. Need to shut that down and head back to Helios Station.
A jamming signal? Haven't noticed anything like that. You might want to get to Concordia, a little city run by a fella called the Merith. Got to be somebody there who can help you. You'll need an O2 kit, Oz kits we call them, to survive the journey though. I've got some broken ones stashed nearby, but I can repair them for you. Even if you ain't the breathing type, you'll be glad you've got an Oz kit. Head to these coordinates and clear the place out.
Seriously, I have to go there without one? Holy shit. Oh, but there are... Okay, cool. There are oxygen sources along the way. Neat. Good stuff. Let's go.
Oh, crap.
I don't know if you can hear that. I don't know how low I've turned the volume down for editing purposes, but every time he walks out without air, he's like, oh, crap. So is this an oxygen spot? Cool. I didn't know... Well, I guess this isn't the moon. I didn't know there'd be... Could be gases stored underneath the. Well, I guess there could be, but still, kind of cool. Uh oh.
That building used to be in one piece and not lava adjacent until the crackening, anyway.
Crackening? What? The fuck is a crackening? Go! We're almost there. Thank you.
I forgot I locked it. Whoops. Just punch off the locks with your meat hunks. That's moon for hands.
Meat hunks? Meat hunks. Sure. Alrighty. Oh. What? Oh. This is cool.
For me too. Not excited about being mauled again.
Good stuff. And hang on, not done yet. Still exploring. I need my loot fix. Just one more chest, I swear. Just one more. That's it.
Voila.
Then I'm done.
One Ozkit. Great for breathing, double jumping, and slamming enemies. Now, to repay me for saving your life, you're gonna end someone else's. His name's Deadlift. He's nearby, and he's an asshole. He's also got something I'll need to get us into Concordia.
It's good to know he's an asshole, then, I guess. If I was just killing a dude, then, hey, maybe not. Nope. Hey, there you are.
Why don't we just make up a word that rhymes with orange?
Sure. What?
Deadlift leads a band of scavengers, scavs, who used to raid the old Dahl dig site. Colonel Zarpadon imprisoned them, but they escaped when Dahl's digging cracked the moon.
I'm sorry, Zarpadon?
Anyway, he's got the Digistract key for my Zoomy stations. Killing him will get you to Concordia and make my week. Win-win.
This sounds like such a fake name. Ozkits, you have tamed an Ozkit. It provides a supply of O2, which drains in a vacuum and recharges an atmosphere. So it's not a permanent fix. Okay. Well, off the ground, press A to boost, burning O2 to glide and maneuver. Tap B to quickly return to the ground. Hold B to slam. Interesting. Consuming or causing an impact shockwave around you. All right, let's give it a try. Actually kind of curious. So, boom. So, a bit of a hover. That is freaking awesome, man. Little ones? No. No, little ones. Punched it with my meat gloves or whatever the fuck it was. There's a lot of these things. I kind of need to heal. I don't remember how. I don't think I have. Actually, no. That's right. I didn't buy any healing things. Alright, sounds good. Just wait. Were there any healy-rooney things in here? No. Awesome. Alright, where am I going? Hang on. Where am I going? We're going way out of the way. All right. Sounds good to me. Oh, there were a healer or anything.
Warning, zero atmosphere environment.
Ooh. Ooh, what's that blue? Baby blue. I have no idea. Oh, is that O2? It might have been O2. Oh, okay. You know, I'm digging this, man. This is cool. This is far different than what I remember it being. Well, again, most of my experience was with Borderlands 1 and a few hours of Borderlands 2, so it's not really to compare. But, or not much to compare, but it is still pretty freaking sweet, man. And if there's one thing this game does really well, it's gunplay. It may be fairly simplistic, but it is still damn fun. Hey, quit tail whipping me, you assholes. That's really cool too. There's one good way to get around the whole constantly floating thing. That's pretty neat. I like that. Wait, does that consume? Nah, it doesn't look like it does. This definitely does, though, yeah.
I don't think you ever told me why you want Deadlift killed.
He's kind of a dick.
Oh, okay. Oh, I'm sorry, wait, what?
Well, he also stole my Moonzumi Digistruct key, stranded me out here, and got really rude when I told him I wasn't into guys. But mainly the being a dick thing.
She's all about taco crushing. It's funny because I've met a few people that are like that. Obviously I've met a few people that were lesbians. But what I mean is that I've met a few people that get really upset when a girl's like, yeah, no, I don't roll that way. I'm actually into women. And I was like, oh, come on, why you be like that? It's like, what the fuck, dude? Calm down. Yeah, so if this guy's a dick, I can get behind that. That's fine with me. Dick's a dick. Let's go kill him.
This is Colonel Zarpadon.
Zarpadon.
Things are about to get much worse. I don't want to kill you if I don't have to.
Hail, Zarpadon!
You've already, killed a whole bunch of people.
Fine. Do what you will. Deadlift, this is Colonel Zarpadon. I need you to kill the Vault Hunters headed for your ship.
Get bent, Zarp. I ain't taking orders from the chick who threw me in prison.
They said your jump pads are stupid.
I will annihilate them.
That's funny. Okay, let's go. Next area. I will annihilate them. Just, yeah, we didn't say they were stupid. You're kind of a dick, but, didn't say they were stupid.
Annihilate.
Alrighty, let's see what they got. They got anything better?
Feeling overburdened by money.
Oh, cool. So you can actually buy new upgraded Oz kits. Nice. We're gonna wait, though. I don't think we really need any right now.
You're my millionth customer. Don't let it go to your head. Nothing like a good sale.
Alrighty. Now, real quick, I want to buy some health kits. Now, do they not have that anymore? Is insta health the only thing you can get? Ooh. How much is that? Oh, we don't have enough. Oh wait, no, we do. I can sell stuff. There. Let's buy a new shield. Actually, wait. 475. I'm always about, capacity. I've never been about numbers. I'm about capacity. I'm not about recharge delay and all that stuff. But at the same time, that's not bad. Nah, we'll wait. I think we're okay. 53 is pretty low, though. Nah, screw it. We're okay. We're okay for now. Uh-oh. That's actually kind of cool. That's actually pretty neat. I like that. Whoa! Mercenaries!
I will soar into the air!
Soar.
Crush you with a butt slam!
Soar! That really thick Australian accent. Come on, other Jacks. Jacks. Digi Jacks.
Jack here. The real one.
Shut up. No, you're not. You're the false Jack.
Kill some bad guy.
Stuff. Ooh, what do we got here? Nothing. Ooh, you are actually better. I'm gonna use you. And you are even better. Let's take a look. First, open. Open sesame. I was trying to figure out, like, why are they popping open like that? They're pressurized, or the air differential is different. So it's oxygen escaping. That's really cool. That's a nice little touch, actually. Okay, real quick, let me... Oops. Look at weapons here. So replace that, but how does this compare? Magazine size is a little bit bigger. Significantly bigger. And reload speed's bigger, but everything else... Yeah, I'm gonna use that for a while.
Which one of you is least crappy?
Here, we'll use this. It's okay, we'll use it. Sure. Alrighty, can I get up here? Maybe not. Cool, just follow the path. Oh, so we're actually gonna go, oh, we are going to kill him, never mind. That's what we were sent out here to begin with. Yeah, but I hope everything looks pretty good. Like I said, I am using the new Elgato HD60 that I bought. HD60 Pro, rather. So it is a different capture card. It is the one I've been using for streaming, so you know, hopefully it looks relatively okay. Yeah, I don't know if I like this gun. Yeah, bugger. No one's as good as a fake Jack as me. I'm the best fake Jack. The one and only.
Let's kill some bad guys.
Punch in the chest and he's out. Oh, wait, did I? No, I didn't go past. What? Wait. Oh, we need to get in there. Oh, I see. We can probably just jump this, can't we? Oh, yeah, we can jump that. But before I do that, I'm actually kind of curious. There was an exclamation point back here. I want to see what that is. I want to see what that is before we actually head over there, because there might be something interesting-ish over here, maybe. Probably not. We'll see, though. Ow, you dick! Walkabout! I fucking love it, it's so cool. Little scav? Oh, I'm almost dead. Oh, that's right, I forgot that they have a second, second chance thing. Or second wind? That was wind. Sure. But whatever it is, it basically it brings you back to life if you heal someone. If you don't kill someone, you'll just revive. Okay, fake Jacks. Keep my watch my back. I'm looting. Level up. Woo. You level up pretty quick in this game. Space rookie. Yo! $25. Not too bad. There's something over here. Did you bury me with a beer? My man. Is that door even attached to anything? Doesn't look like it. We'll pick it up. I forget how often enemies drop things. Pretty much all the time. Guns and things, I mean. Holy shit. Ow! Nice. Alrighty. Oh, so this... No, this is, that's What's-Her-Face. Yeah, see, that's What's-Her-Face back at the, shit, back at the place we first started in. Okay. Never mind. Never mind. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go kill ourselves, the dude. I had to look it over there. I had no idea what his name was. I mean, and that's the thing, is that even though there is an overlying story to the series now, myself and probably quite a significant amount of people still play the game as if there was no story. Hey, just play it just to play it, you know, it's that sort of thing. Integrity. You deal increased gun damage against enemies who are below 40% health. The enemy previously, an enemy is under pressure to deal even more gun damage. Oh, cool. That's actually kind of neat. Collaborate. Whenever DigiJack dies, you gain a stack of collaborate. You and your DigiJacks deal increased damage for every stack of collaborate you have. Ah. Yes, you. I like that. Jeez. I always forget that there's different classes you can look at. Free Enterprise... Creator good, or greater good, and the hero of the story. What is this? Increases weapon swap speed. That's not bad. Swapping weapons increases fire rate for a short time. Each stack lasts 10 seconds, and all stacks are lost if you do not swap within the 10 seconds. Wow, that's actually kind of interesting. Increase maximum health of your digijacks. Additionally, the longer a digijack is alive, the more damage it does. Ha, ha, ha. Let's do this, though. Yeah, I like that. All right, cool. If I do decide to continue this, and if you guys want to see this during the stream or whatever, I will definitely continue playing as this character here. Sorry for the airplane noises. Again, sorry for any noises you've heard during the video. I forget how loud it is, actually, outside my apartment. Oh, that's great.
I disabled the jump pad! Forgive me, jump pad. I didn't mean it.
Crap. Better head up to that geothermal substation, see what the damage is.
So, the place we just were. Okay, cool. So, I think we've already cleared all the enemies out. Well, the game does have a habit of respawning people, so maybe there are going to be more people there.
Warning. Oxygen levels at 50% and dropping.
Don't let those hoity-toity Hyperion goons take one more step.
Too late. I already cleared everyone from here. Everyone is dead. Cool. Hoity-toity. Thank you, thank you. Ow. Ow.
Oh, fuse is busted. Got an idea, though. You could be the fuse.
Oh, that's...
If you complete the circuit between those two live wires, it should reactivate the jump pad. Just stand between the two sparky bits.
Isn't that going to burn me or anything?
Yep, gonna hurt lots.
Oh, fun.
Now just go kill the guy so you can get to Concordia.
Why are those Hyperion screwbags still alive?
Still alive. I love it, man. It's so exaggerated.
Let's get sexy.
Come on, Digijax. Do your thing. Is that it?
Yeah, the world just got 25% more handsome. Let's kill some bad guys.
Alrighty. Jump pad active. Let's go.
Who needs a hero?
This should be a lot of fun.
You got the right jump pads?
I never got to ride a jump pad.
I also witnessed the deaths of many innocent people.
But jump pads,
attention,
though.
But jump pads, though. Show you where their priorities are. I already have full grenades. Okay. Good deal. No and no. Full up on everything. Awesome. Yo, dude. Jump pads. Ugh, get up there.
Deadlift time!
Well, this is gonna be fun.
There he is. Just kill his dumb ass and I can get you closer to Concordia and finding that jamming signal.
Those Vault Hunters die today, or my name isn't Bucephalus Deadlift McElroy.
That's a hell of a name. Where'd he go? Where'd you go? Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Where'd he go? There he is. My mind. Oh no! Hang on, let me finish this fight. So that's an hour. Normally we end it here, but I am in the middle of a fight and I kind of want to finish it or die. Yeah, whichever one comes first. This is a really slow reloading gun, though.
The muscles are leaking.
There we go. Easy peasy.
Now find the Digistruct key. Must be somewhere around here.
Whoa, this thing is really weak. I got a rare gun though.
And the world just got 25% more handsome.
Alright, real quick, we'll get the Digistruct key and then we'll call quits. Whoop. So it must be right up here. Let's go. Oh, hang on. There's always a big loot chest after every boss fight. Or mostly. Sometimes. Not all of them, sometimes. What?
Bonza! Am I glad to see that? Pick it up! Now you've got the Digistruct key, you can turn on one of my moon zoomies at the Dar way station. Get yourself there, but be careful. The scavs have taken over that place after the crackening.
Why was it in the toilet? It's kind of weird. Here we go. Weapons. Ooh, what do we got? Nothing really that great. I'm gonna pick up everything, but nothing fantastic. There we go. That's a good one. Alrighty. So yeah, with that, I'm gonna leave it here, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this return, I guess you could say, of Let's Take a Crack At. Now, let's talk about the game first. So, what did I think of the game? I actually quite enjoyed it. It was a really fun experience, and I had a good time with it. A lot more than I thought I was going to, because a lot of people did say that the pre-sequel was the weakest of the Borderlands games. Now again, this is coming from someone who has never finished a Borderlands game, has sunk quite a fair amount of time into 1 and 2, but never finished them outright. So, if you've never played 1, this is a good place to start, I guess. If you don't want to play the first one, which, like I said, is kind of getting a little dated at this point, so it is... It's fine, but it's also eh at the same time. So yeah, if you don't want to play that, I would say play this, because in order it goes 1, pre-sequel, and then 2. So, yeah, this is pretty cool. And if you do have a PS4 or an Xbox One, definitely pick up the Handsome Collection, because it is well worth it. It's like, I got mine for like $30. Maybe it's even 20. And you get the pre-sequel and 2 running at 1080p, 60fps, with, I think, most, if not all, of the DLC for both games. So, you're getting a pretty good value. A pretty good value on the game. But the gunplay is just like I remember. The characters I love. The story's better. The story's more like what Telltale was. Or, sorry. What Telltale's Tales from the Borderlands was. Because the comedy was kind of there in 1. I mean, it was more situational humor. But in this one, it's pretty funny writing throughout. And I really do appreciate that. So, yeah, if you did like this, let me know. Would you like to see this during the live stream? And if you've watched the very end of the video, let me know as well. Because you guys are fantastic. Kind of put it like a, hey, I watched the end of the video, if you did, in the comments section down below. But besides that, that'll wrap it up for this episode. Now moving over to what's going to be special. Starting in 2016, any episode I do of... Let's Take a Crack At will be more, not necessarily more edited, but more formatted. So like how I've, in the past, I've, even in this episode, I began with the intro, moved into the options, looking at the options menu, the gameplay, and then the closing. We're pretty much going to have intro, we're going to have like transitional things for that. And beginning with episode 50 is when we're going to start having more professional looking stuff to the channel. So 2016 is going to be a good year of growth and innovation, and maybe not even innovation, but growth on the channel. So yeah, hope you guys are excited for that. But anyway, I want to thank you for watching. I've been HelloJapan once more. This has been episode 48 of Let's Take a Crack At. And today we took a crack at Borderlands, the pre-sequel on the Xbox One. And I approve. It's a pretty good version of it. I'll see you guys next time. See ya.